First Class Radio, WMRC, WMRCDailyNews.com, and a happy Sunday night to your late afternoon, folks. It's Ray Auger, along with his wife, Molly, or my wife, Molly, his wife. I'm talking to you in the third person. Hi, Molly. How are you?
Excellent. Excellent. How are you?
We're talking to you on the radio as if you're somebody I just met, an acquaintance. My wife, Molly. Well, we're going to be broadcasting live from the Milford Santa Parade, and the runners are running by now. We just saw our first runner for the first year. They're doing a road race before the actual parade begins. The Milford Fire Department teamed up with the Tri-Valley Front Runners. They're going from the Birch Street fire station to the Spruce Street fire station. Here comes another runner dressed as Santa Claus.
Excellent form.
As the crowd down here cheers them on. Lots of people lined up as it is a beautiful night here in Milford. We're right outside the town hall broadcasting live. We'll have some special guests on throughout the night. We'll be talking about some of the floats that are coming by. We're hanging out with our friends from Milford TV. Craig is back at the studios manning the board. And he's also going to try to cut in with me. But, hey, Craig, just say something right now just so I can make sure I can hear you. Okay, you're very light, so I'm afraid I'm not going to be able to hear you when Tom calls in.
Will you buy me a plastic SpongeBob?
No, I won't buy you a plastic SpongeBob.
Oh, come on.
And I'm so glad our kids aren't with us right now to see those because they will want them. Because nothing says Christmas
like a plastic SpongeBob.
Like a plastic SpongeBob. And a popcorn gun.
And
how old am I? Do they still make popcorn pork guns? And some of the other races are running by. It's really nice because the runners are dressed up in the Christmas spirit. They got the Christmas spirit. There's some little kids.
This little kid.
Yeah, he's got an American flag. That's nice.
Aww.
This kid can't be any more than what? 7 years old? Six?
No, he's like five.
You think he's a five-year-old?
He's five.
Okay.
He's doing a great job.
He sure is.
Is this like the Heartbreak Hill portion of the race?
Yes.
It's upcoming. Oh, and here's another little one.
It's elevation of 3%, I think, but it's almost like Heartbreak Hill, yes.
Good job, Tapal.
Great to see the runners from the Tri-Valley Front Runners. We hear some fire engines approaching the town hall area as the parade has kicked off. Let's see, it's 4:13. Now, I'm assuming that it's going to be a few more minutes, and Malcolm Zale dancing in the street. Our entertainment for tonight.
Look at the moves. Jeez.
Look at him go.
Wow.
And he's not even stopping. He's not, like at this point, a normal person would stop and it'd be like, it's over, I'm done, that's what I did. But he's still going, folks. He's the Energizer Bunny on crack, is what we think.
And Tim Rice is now saying stop.
does this child have parents, by the way? Is there somebody that can claim him? Malcolm Zale, great kid. He works for Milford TV and does a great job and just gets better and better the more he works for Milford TV.
Whipping and naying.
Hey, come on up. Why? You feeling unloved or something, Joey?
I just wanted to say hi.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you very much. And great to see you last night at the benefit that we had at Liz's.
I've got to tell you, Ray, you do an amazing job at that stuff.
I can't do it without the support of you guys and everybody at Liz's.
How much did you
MRC.
Get out of that?
Well, we get $1,200 cash.
It's amazing.
Yeah, and then all the toys that were collected.
Right.
They were just taking bags to the truck back and forth. There were maybe five or six bikes that people
yeah,
donated.
Yeah, I did see a lot of bikes.
So that was nice.
I can't believe that. I mean, that's amazing.
Yeah.
I understand why WMRC wins all these awards.
The school committee.
Yes.
What brought you to join the school committee or actually be elected to the school committee?
My kids, to be honest with you. I mean, a lot of stuff that goes around the town, you want to be a part of it and help out and actually see what happens behind the scenes. And
yeah,
if I could be any part of that and help out, love to do it. And I enjoy every minute of it.
Was it everything you thought it would be, or is it?
It's nothing like I thought it would
okay.
be. At all. I knew it was a challenge, and I'm not a political person.
Yeah,
I don't like politics, but
yeah,
to go through the whole election and everything was a challenge for me.
Yeah.
But winning and going through the steps and learning everything, never in a million years did I think I'd be doing something
that's funny
like this and loving every minute of it.
So what are you looking forward to? Let's talk parade stuff.
I am excited that it's not 3 degrees outside.
It's nice out, right? This is beautiful. I'm thinking about taking the sweatshirt off.
I'm dying. I've got Under Armour on like you wouldn't believe. It's crazy.
But you must come year after year.
Yeah, last year, actually, you know what? I don't think I've seen these for like, I don't know how many years. It was like the 28th one. I think I've seen
this
20
is 29.
Of them. 29.
I believe
like
it's 29.
20
yeah.
of them.
You see, I used to come when I was a kid because I didn't grow up in the area, but
right.
my family was here. So my Uncle Ron would skate down,
oh, yeah?
down Main Street, and he would lead the parade. So we'd come out to visit, and we'd watch the parade. And I just remember it being packed. The whole route. Last few years, granted, it's been cold, a little sparse.
Right.
Tonight, I mean, you look around where we are at the town hall, and it's pretty full.
It's not bad. When we were coming off the highway, and I was thinking I'd have to go down Birch Street and come down Cedar, I mean, Central Street and everything. We went right by, and you could still see it was kind of dismal, but yep. Getting further and further in, it starts to pick up.
Now, they award the best float, the best entry. Do you have a front runner in mind?
Have you put any money down on anyone?
No. If you were a betting man? I think it was the Italian Vets that won last year.
They always do a good job. A lot of good people down there.
They had Mickey Ward, I think, on the float
last year. Well, we were in it last year as well. The team that I helped coach football, my son's team.
Yeah.
We got together. We decided why not put the kids in the parade.
Hello, Craig. Thank you very much. And we're back here at the town hall as we broadcast live from the Santa Parade, the 29th annual Santa Parade. We can hear the sirens coming up Main Street. And we want to talk to Jamie Crivello. Come on up here, Jamie Crivello.
I'm making my way up.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. So you ran the race.
I did.
Which means you're not going to be on the tradesman float.
No, I'm not, unfortunately.
That's too bad.
But I won't run the race. I have to work at the tradesman tonight. So.
Are you working tonight? Okay, so you can go see Jamie tonight. Go check out some football because we got the Pats are on now.
On now,
and you can head out to the tradesman to check out the Pats after the parade here.
Yeah.
How was the race?
The race was good. It was 2 miles. We started at the Birch Street Fire Station, made our way downtown, and ended up at the Spruce Street Fire Station.
Yeah.
It was put on by the Tri-Valley Front Runners,
okay.
who are a running group that I just recently joined.
Oh,
they're
nice.
Wonderful people.
Do you run a lot, obviously?
I do.
You joined a group.
I do, yeah. But this was the first year us doing it. Everyone brought a non-perishable food item, so we're donating that to the food pantry. And a portion of the race funds are going to go to the Milford Firefighters.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Good.
So
for
a good
stuff
race.
Like this.
Yeah, yeah, for stuff like this.
So are you excited about the parade?
I am.
Do you come every year?
I do, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Who are you looking forward to seeing?
I'm excited to see the tradesmen float. I'm a little biased, but it is their first year.
It's been a big mystery.
Yeah.
Because our friend Karen was involved in putting it together. And
I know the secret,
you
but
do?
I'm not going to say
secret?
Anything.
Oh.
No, it's not really a secret. But
now, Rubber Chicken Comics teamed up
with them,
I believe. So it's a Rubber Chicken Comics / tradesmen float. So we're going to say goodbye to Jamie.
Yes.
Thank you, Jamie. Great to see you.
Great to see you, too.
We're going to go because it's going to start getting really loud with the sirens.
So everyone have fun.
Thanks, Jamie.
Bye.
Jamie Crivello. And go say hi to her at the tradesmen tonight. So we'll take it as long as we can. And as I mentioned, the fire department is coming up the street, followed by other towns. Now it's getting loud. So let's take a break here. And Craig's going to play some Christmas music. We're broadcasting live from the town hall for the 2015 Santa Parade here in Milford. And we'll be right back.
Thank you.
Paul's truck. Paul bought that. Yeah. We are back live here at the Town Hall in Milford for the annual Milford Santa Parade. The fire trucks just went by, and followed by the new Braza Mancini fire truck. Paul Braza bought a fire truck for Braza Mancini, and this is its debut ride through the parade. That was pretty cool. Yeah, it had the whole staff, and I'm sure friends and family riding in there, throwing candy. So we're here, my wife Molly and myself, here at the Milford Santa Parade. And we're going to start seeing some of the floats and some of the entries and vehicles making their way up Main Street as we are celebrating Christmas here in Milford, downtown Milford, 29th annual.
Hey, everyone.
Hey.
Hey.
all right, so let's. Can we get Justin up here really quick? Justin Redden?
Yeah, he's hanging on
ready.
One second. He's tending to his little ones.
Come on up, Justin. Justin and I do an acoustic duo throughout the Milford area, the greater Milford area, called Justin and Ray. I don't know where we came up with the name. Come on up here. Stand up next to me so you can be on Milford TV as well.
Great. Now I'm on TV.
How are you? I know. It's kind of tight down there.
I'm currently stuck.
All right, we'll step down. How about that?
You can go back up if that makes you feel more comfortable.
Well, sometimes I feel a little taller. This is nice once in a while. How are you?
I'm good, man. How's it going?
Good. You grew up here.
I did.
In Milford.
Yep.
And always came to the parade here?
Not until I had kids.
Oh, really? Okay. Was that a thing? Was that a towny thing? It's like, yeah, maybe we'll go to the parade, maybe we won't.
Yeah, well, you know, when I was growing up, I was just talking to a friend of ours. You know, there was so much other stuff that happened here, like, you know, 4th of July.
Yeah.
I don't remember the Santa Parade being anything big.
Really? It was just one of those things because Milford had so much going on.
Yeah, so now it's like when they do it, it's, you know, I think it's a really great community event. You know, it's one of the few things where you see, like, all the different things. Like, the fire department does a great job, and then they get other businesses and community involved. So,
yeah,
it's a really cool thing to see. You know, the kids get a kick out of it.
What's happening in the world of Justin Redden? What's musically?
Well, it's just Justin and Ray, really. So whatever you're doing, I'm doing, really.
Well, we've got our fringe benefits thing that we do.
Yeah, that's fun. I really like doing that. You know, it's all the... It lets me be in a band without really being in a band.
All the bowl that goes along with it, yeah.
Yeah, I don't think I don't have time for that. So
Justin and I just did a benefit for a young girl, Danny, who has cancer, who's in remission, by the way. Congratulations
to
Danny.
That's fantastic.
She's
that's
in
really
remission.
Great to hear.
We raised some money for her. We played at Skioli's with our band Fringe Benefits, and that's what we do. We get together and we play benefits. And then we teamed up with another benefit-like band called Charity Case, and we had just a fun night. So thank you for your participation in that.
I love doing that. So anytime I have the chance to do stuff for charity, you know, I do this for fun. I do it to get out and have a good time and stuff like that. Anytime we can kind of give back a little bit and you know, give back to the community and members of the community, that's stuff I like to do.
You came out last night and played a song with Tollbooth Willie.
Yeah, always fun.
The toy benefit last night at Liz's, so thanks for that.
Of course.
Good to see you. I'll let
good
you get back
you,
to the parade. Enjoy the parade.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Enjoy, have fun.
Absolutely, always.
Here you go, Molly.
So we're broadcasting live from the Milford Santa Parade here in Milford with our friends Milford TV. You got to check out their lineup. MilfordTV.net is the website. They got the full lineup there. Hey, Erica. Hey.
Hey.
What's happening? How are you? And they've just got a great great series of programming, and including some things that we're involved with, like Living for the Weekend and Distracted Driving. My wife, Molly, joins me here. And this is where it gets difficult for us. We've got lights on us, and it's starting to get dark. So as the parade progresses up Main Street and it gets darker, we're going to do our best to shout out to all the businesses and all the organizations that are coming by. But I do see some lights coming up. It's about to get festive, folks. I can tell. Look at that. That looks awesome, and I don't know who that is.
It does. We'll find out. We'll find out soon enough.
Yeah, so we've got some special guests that are going to be coming in and out throughout the broadcast tonight. We're going to get a visit from Selectman Kincaid. He's going to be coming by. I just got a message from him saying streets are blocked. Trying to make my way up there. Oh, I hear Ronnie Auger.
Oh.
People think that I'm him, he's me. We have the same voice. Do we even have the, he's there, I'm here. So that's the big difference. That's Ronnie Auger.
That is Ronnie.
Tim Rice's favorite guy right there. That's Ronnie Auger.
Is he on roller skates this year?
I believe Tim and Ron are friends on Facebook. I think they have spirited conversations from time to time.
The man is walking.
Is he on? No, he's on? Okay. So this guy, Ron Auger, happens to be an uncle of mine. And he gives up his time every year for the Milford Santa Parade. And he leads the progression up and down Main Street. And he always does a great job. Procession. I say progression. Procession is what I meant to say.
Uncle Ronnie, DJ Ron is always a fun guy.
So enjoy, everyone. Are you all having a good time?
There he is.
You can hear him in the background.
I want to say to you all, Merry Christmas. Oh, I'm going to say it one more time. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, that's what I love to hear. Merry Christmas, everybody. WMRC Radio.
Uncle Ronnie.
Molly, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas,
Merry
Uncle
Christmas.
Ronnie. And who's driving the car? Is that Robbie? That's my cousin Robbie driving the car. Probably Anthony's in there. Mwah, to you too. Here's Anthony.
Are you guys waiting for Santa?
I see some minions here. And we have our one of our first entries, Red Line. Oh, yes, this is Lily. And unfortunately, we lost Lily recently. But her family decided that they wanted to be in the parade this year in honor of Lily.
Wonderful.
So this is all for Lily right here. Merry Christmas.
They're pulling a cat. Looks great, all lit up.
And they have a minion on there as well.
You know, it's got to be festive with minions.
Absolutely. I've seen a lot of minions. That seems to be a theme so far. And coming up next is the Milford Fire Department. And they've got a festive-looking crew on their float, throwing out candy.
You know, people are doing a really good job on these floats.
I told you.
Lit up.
And tomorrow, a lot of these people go into planning for next year. And they really take this thing seriously. Oh, and Dunkin' Donuts is in the back there. I think it's Dunky. I think that's Dunky, the Dunkin' Donuts coffee. On the other side, we can't see him.
Big fan of his.
Milford Fire Department, thanks for all you do. Wonderful, wonderful fire department here in Milford. We're lucky to have those guys and our surrounding communities, as we saw the fire departments from all our surrounding towns going through a little bit earlier on. I believe that's, is that Ira? Ira Toyota?
That is Ira Toyota.
Coming up, Rob, it's another Ira Toyota truck with a Christmas tree in the back. That's nice.
Nice looking truck.
We tried doing lights on a vehicle and failed, I think, 3 years in a row. Remember that? It just didn't work.
It was a valiant effort, but it was a big fail with a capital
F. It was just the car.
Yeah.
It was just the car driving through with no lights on it. I believe
band.
This is Milford High School marching band now coming through.
Were playing you in your marching band?
I was not in the marching band. I was on the football team. But I had a lot of friends that was on the marching band. And you know what? It's funny. The older you get, the more you appreciate what they're doing, almost more so than the football players. These guys are amazing. And they're playing some Jingle Bells.
They look great. They all have Santa hats on. Their drums are lit up.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. They're all lit up. Everything's battery operated now.
We need to get one of these.
Yes. What is that? That is a. It's like a monster truck mini go-kart. Is somebody driving that? Or is that a remote control? Is somebody in that?
I don't think anybody's in that. I think that's remote. We need to get one of those.
And this is also a Smiles for Lily remote control. I think it's a remote control car.
Wow.
That might be Dan Duess. That might be his doing, Dan Duess. Because there's a bike. There's a mini bike on the back as well. But this is Smiles for Lily. And as mentioned, we lost with Lily, unfortunately. But the family decided they really wanted to be a part of this in honor of Lily. And there's Will Kincaid, our selectman here, one of our selectmen's in town. And come on up. Come on up, Will. Watch your step. Come over this side. No, jump on. Jump behind me. Molly's going to give you the headset there. Grab her headset. There you go. Will Kincaid, one of our selectmen here. Be careful. We'll step down. How are you, man?
Good. How are you?
Good. Good to see you.
Good. Thanks for having me.
Did you run up here?
A little bit. I planned on being a little earlier.
How was your time? Because there was a race before. Did you beat a few people?
Yeah. No, I haven't walked since I got my license.
Good to see you.
You too.
How exciting is this, right?
It's awesome.
Every year, do you come down and enjoy this?
Every year since I was a kid.
This is one of those rare years where it's actually warm out. Well, not warm, but it's tolerable.
It's beautiful.
King Dance Academy is coming up, and I think I have something about King Dance Academy. Yes, I do. They're dancing on Main Street to Marshmallow World and Winter Wonderland. Academy is under the direction of Carlene Goldberg, and we want to say hi to all the kids in the King Dance Academy group. And they're dancing along to some Christmas music. Who are you looking forward to seeing?
Oh, I like, not to be diplomatic, but I like everybody. I know Old Time Auto's coming.
Yep, Rudy's going to be coming up.
My classmate, Rudy Leoch,
oh,
great
nice.
Guy, good
great
family.
Guy. Absolutely. These are just a few. I mean, there are, I don't know, how many entries would you think is in this parade? It gets bigger and bigger every year.
Bigger, I mean.
It's got to be like 60?
At least.
60, 70?
And I heard Braza Construction bought a fire truck.
Yeah, it just went by.
Did
it?
I missed it?
It followed the other fire trucks. It's very cool.
Oh,
yeah.
That's awesome.
Want to talk about town hall stuff, or do you just want to talk about
I'll talk about whatever you want.
How are things in town hall these days?
Yeah, things are good.
Yeah, I was talking to Joey Callery. Were you always a politician?
Was I?
Yeah.
For the last 20 years.
Okay, because Joey Callery wasn't, and then he ran for school committee, and he's like, this is exciting, but so new and different. Was it what you thought it was going to be?
Absolutely.
It was. Okay.
It was. School committee was a lot of work, and different because when you're dealing with people's children and things like that, there's a lot more emotions I learned.
Yep.
So far, my last 7 months on the Board of Selectmen, it's pretty much business related. I haven't seen a lot of emotion.
Yep.
Not as much as when you're dealing with people's kids.
Right.
So it's different. it's great. It's just a lot different.
Well, you're doing a great job for the town.
No, I appreciate that.
Milford Highway Department coming by. These guys also do a great job for our town.
Oh, they certainly do.
Keeping the potholes filled and our streets clean. Girl Scouts are coming through.
Aww.
Oh, and they got their cookies. That's a sign they're leading with. Girl Scout cookies starting in January, of course.
Great marketing.
That's all I need, right? Will Kincaid, ladies and gentlemen, good to see you.
Thank you.
And thanks for coming down, and thanks for making it up here. I know you had to dodge some traffic and some floats to get up here, and appreciate it.
A little bit. Great to see you.
Right,
thanks,
thank you, Will. Are these our friends from Depot Street Tavern? I do not know. No, this is, I don't know. Oh, it's a chop shop, folks. The chop shop, yeah. Great place. I've had my haircut there before. Great people over at the chop shop. And we have another marching band, and I missed the sign. It looks like it might be Holliston.
Blue and white.
Or Hopedale. Might be Hopedale. I don't know. I can't hear. Name that tune.
Nothing.
I don't either.
Did you see the plow?
Jingle bells. Maybe. I don't know. Did I see what?
Did you see that gigantic plow that went by?
Yes.
Fantastic.
The Milford Highway Department.
Fantastic.
All right, here's another entry. North Pole or bus. It's Old Time Auto Sales, ladies and gentlemen. Rudy Leoch.
Rudy!
Francesca is with him, as well as his kids. And Sue Leoch, he mentioned, has been in the parade year after year and decided to watch the parade this year from Josh's new location, her other son, right on Main Street. So Sue is not on there, but we want to say hi to Sue Leoch. Rudy Leoch, great guy, old-time auto sales. Yeah, great. Yes, that's right. He coached our kids. And the Outlaws hockey, ladies and gentlemen. Let's say hi to Eric and the Outlaws.
Handing out candy.
So much youth sports. Oh, they're on skates. They're on rollerblades. I tried that once.
Yeah.
Once.
Oh, we got a spillage.
Kids are throwing out candy. I was saying that there's so many youth sports options in this town.
It's great.
It really is, and in our surrounding areas as well. So we say hi to the Outlaws as they come by. Can you reach me? No one has thrown candy to us yet. Let's see if you can do it. Oh. Nice, almost.
Come on, use that arm. Okay.
That is on top of the roof of Nice.
Excellent.
So we're broadcasting live from the Milford Santa Parade here in Milford. Milford TV joins us for a later broadcast, and we always enjoy working with them and hanging out with them and our friends there. Thank you. I think we have enough candy. Did you just hit Malcolm?
Malcolm might have gotten dinged.
Malcolm Zale is working hard out on the street with his Steadicam, getting shots of the parade. There seems to be, I don't know, three or four or five cameras maybe here?
I'd say four.
filming everything that's happening downtown. There's so many people out on the streets, and this is really, every year is amazing, and this whole parade is amazing, but to see the, hey, Jim LaGore, ladies and gentlemen, to see the camaraderie, the community come out and support this and be a part of this as Milford Dance Center comes by. Hello, Milford Dance Center. Good to see you. But it really is a special day as I talk to Jim LaGore. How are you?
Hey, Ray. How are you, buddy?
Good to see you. Be careful. That's tight as you...
That is tight.
Yeah,
wow.
Okay. I'll step down.
That's
but come
okay.
come over here, though, so you get in the camera shot.
Hoopla!
Hoopla.
Wow.
Yeah. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm good.
This is awesome. Like,
great. I mean,
it's the weather.
You don't have, like, 10 layers on like
I'm
you did last year.
I'm not wearing a towel like I did last year.
That's right. And then you disappeared.
And then I disappeared because it got frigidly cold.
Hannaford's is coming up as they pass us by as we talk to Jim LaGore, who is just, he's, you know, you're almost like Mr. Milford.
Oh, well, you know, I'm born and raised here. So.
Right. And you're on a lot of boards.
I am, yep.
So we've been talking politics with Will Kincaid and Joey Callery.
Very nice.
How do you like working for the town, basically, on the boards?
You know, I got to tell you, it's something that it means a lot to me. I've been on the personnel board for about 10 years. Rob, good to see you. I've been on the personnel board for about 10 years. I just, was appointed to the board at MPAC, too.
That's right. Yes,
to
the two of us, yeah.
Your nomination. So for me, it's important. It's a way to give back to the community. It's important to me.
You do a lot.
So.
And you do a lot musically as well. Your band Zero Drift. You also have Sidetracks, which is a group of musicians that are just writing music. And we talk about this on Living for the Weekend.
Yes.
But that's exciting, too. All local musicians get together in your basement. You have a home studio.
Yes.
Well, you have a home studio.
Yes, I do.
It's not as creepy as it sounds. You have a legitimate studio.
We do. Everybody gets together in my basement, and we kind of...
And you're writing and recording music, and original music. And we heard some of that last time on Living for the Weekend on Friday.
It was very good. It's always a pleasure to be on your show. That's for sure.
Mulvaney Landscaping is coming by. Look at that. They're all dressed up all festively. Some elves on there tossing out some candy as well. Who are you looking forward to seeing?
I don't have a favorite this year. I was happy to see as soon as we came out of the gym, because we were at Jacob's basketball for the last 3 hours. And the first thing I said to Jill was, look at all the people. You remember last year?
Yeah.
It was frigid.
Yep.
And it was hardly anyone out here. But it's so great to see the community come out and the streets are lined with people. And this is really what it's all about.
It is. Everyone is out tonight. Shades of Green is coming by us. Waving to the, saying hi to the, oh, and the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer is on there.
The question is, how did, and I know Molly's standing right here next to you, but, how many floats did we have last year versus this year?
This is one of the bigger parades anyway, but I think there's got to be twice as many. I know a lot didn't show up last year and the year before because of the rain.
Right.
But a night like this, I think they were coming out of the woodwork, especially when they got the news of the weather. I'm sure they added a lot few days.
Because, just to me, coming out, it looks like there were a lot more, everybody seems to be closer together, space closer together. Last year, remember, you had to,
They
were staggering them a little further.
And we had to, it was tough because we had to kind of just banter.
Yeah, which remember
in some situations, it isn't always my strong suit. But
thank God you were here because I don't even know what I would have done. It was like being opposite Dick Clark. It was. I felt like Ryan Seacrest, but in the early stages of
learning from Dick Clark. Okay. Bona Onda, our new show for the Portuguese-speaking community is coming by. And it's hey, everybody, there they are. You can hear them Sunday mornings. You heard them this morning. There they are right there. Bona Onda, ladies and gentlemen, and the whole crew from the radio show. Looking good. They got their banner out there, and you can hear them Sunday mornings at 9 o'clock on First Class Radio WMRC and streaming live and on demand in the media center at WMRCDailyNews.com.
Very
hey,
nice.
Good to see you, brother.
Thank you very much for having me on. I'll get
enjoy
you back
the rest of the parade.
Thank you.
Let's see, and I'm trying to just check out banners as they come by, and I'm going to miss a few here and there, but we want to thank everybody who participated in the parade this year. And as Jim said, I think there's a lot more involved, and it's nice to see. I'm going to step up here. It's nice to see because I'm already short enough. I can't be down here because that's just not going to look right. It's good to see so many organizations and businesses involved. And, WMRC is local. We pride ourselves on being local. So being at this parade, and we went to the Medway Parade personally, not the station, but you and I went with the Rices and some of our other friends, and being at that parade was amazing as well. And I just love when towns get together for stuff like that. That was a busy night.
It was a very busy night.
Their route's like a mile long. This one's 2 miles long, and everybody was out for that. And then they do fireworks after the parade every year in Medway, so that was nice. But we are downtown in right outside the town hall, and
I'd say there is. It's twice as many floats.
It's a long one.
And it's twice as many people. There's thousands of people out here.
Well, again, it's hard to see because we have lights on us, but if I can really focus my eyes, I mean, the streets are lined. It is jam-packed down here, which is exciting to see a community come out in today's day and age, 2015, when we've got internet and the Patriots are on right now as well.
But we're here.
So you know.
This is community spirit.
Right. So it warms the heart that people are actually out and enjoying each other, enjoying each other's company and enjoying community and cheering on all the floats that are coming by celebrating the holiday season. And we're broadcasting live through our media center. And of course you know that because you're listening in the media center right now. The Patriots are on First Class Radio WMRC right now. So if you want to turn over at some point and catch the game or after the parade, the game is on. WMRC, 3 hours of post-game action. We always have 3 hours of pre-game and 3 hours of post-game. And of course, the game itself. Coming by now, the Milford Special Olympics. These guys are awesome.
Awesome floats.
Yeah, it's the greater Milford area, but they do so much for the special needs community. And I talked to somebody about it. I can't remember. They blew my mind with a statistic on how many games they actually play throughout the year. And it's grown. It's like 20 or 30 athletic events alone that they take part in. And they're just a wonderful organization, and proud to have them in the community here with us.
They do a great job. Hey, buddy.
It's the First Congregational Church here in Milford.
Big Santa, big nativity scene.
Always a festive crew. They have an entry every year.
You still haven't gotten me my plastic SpongeBob.
You want a plastic SpongeBob? Because then Christmas will be Christmas. It's not Christmas until we get a plastic SpongeBob.
Rudolph is here.
WROR, one of our radio friends coming through the streets of Milford here. I may feel a little like territorial at this moment.
Okay,
but we're going to let it go because it's the Christmas spirit, they are our guests. So welcome ROR, Lauren and Wally, an amazing morning show. Those guys are a lot of fun. And it's nice to see that. I think this is the first time in the parade. So welcome to WROR.
Welcome to Milford.
Yeah, welcome to Milford. Eastern Security Safe, this is one of the largest safes that you will ever see just driving up Main Street. This is an entry that they put in the parade every year. We want to say hello to our friends from Eastern Security Safe Company. And I see Doyle. Oh, this is Doyle. Hey, everybody, it's the Zales.
Hello.
Your kid's going to get run over out there. Doyle siding and window.
Done a great job on our house.
Yeah, there he is. they did. That's right. They did some work on our house. And Kenny Doyle is just such a great guy, and they do a lot with WMRC. You may have heard the commercials that we do, the Jeff Foxworthy parody. Blackstone Valley Model T Club coming by in their Model Ts and other cool vehicles. Broadcasting live right outside the town hall here in Milford for the 2015 Milford Santa Parade. And it is just a beautiful night outside tonight. It's cold. It is December, of course, but it's wonderful. Oh, we have, I think this is the Italian Vets is coming through.
Always a fun crowd.
Yes, these guys are awesome. Erica and Grant and the gang from Italian Vets. Home for the Holidays is the theme of their float this year. And they have these, you see the stockings out here?
I do.
Each one of those stockings is for a veteran. Somebody sponsored the stockings and up on there. And they also have a box for Toys for Tots. They're collecting Toys for Tots. There's representatives from our branches of military, so we welcome them. They're always a lot of fun. They are contenders for the big prize at the at the end of the parade, because everyone is competing for a trophy, and they are going to be defending their trophy. Sweet Wise Ice Cream coming through. They were at the Tradesman Labor Day Bash. Excellent ice cream. The Hawks, here come the Hawks, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for the Hawks.
Wow, look at a big group.
It's a big group of Hawks right there.
All excited to be in the parade.
And why wouldn't you be? Look at the streets. They're lined with people who are cheering and welcoming these kids and these entries. And I mean, it's just a wonderful thing.
They're dancing in the streets.
Hawks football. I believe that's football. Is that football?
I believe so.
And Scioli's. Let's say to our friends over at Scioli's. Say hi to our friends at Scioli's. We were just over there for a benefit. Suzette and Steve, wonderful people. They opened up their back room to us so that we could have our benefit last weekend or 2 weekends ago. And no charge. Just, you know, come on in. We want to give back to the community. And they did. And we had a wonderful night. Their food is amazing over there, too, at Scioli's as well.
I just can't get over how many people are here.
What's been your favorite so far?
My favorite has been, you know, I liked the Braza fire truck.
The fire truck, the Braza Mini 2 fire truck, yep.
That
was the debut of that fire truck. Paul, I think Paul just bought it recently and dressed it all up, so that's making its debut in the parade tonight. Tim Rice is taking pictures, by the way, so you'll be able to see these on his Facebook page and timricephoto.com. That's where you can get more details about Tim Rice, a great local photographer. He's done a lot of work with WMRC. You can see his photo of the day on our Facebook page every morning, and once again, you'll be able to see the photos, and he works pretty quickly. He doesn't like when I say this, but you might be able to see these tonight when you get home. Give him a couple hours. I bet you these will be up.
I do like the dancing troops.
Dancing troops, fun.
The girls and boys that take, you know, dancing in the academies. I think they do a nice job.
The Italian Vets was one of my favorites.
You know what? Look at this. This is great.
So the kids are jumping back into the back of Scioli's truck. And you know what this is? And I'm an idiot for not remembering this, but the kids from the Mighty Mites, they're the ones that whipped the Nadeade on the video. They were whipping in Nadeade. Yes, and Steve is their coach, and they were on Living for the Weekend, Steve and his son. But these are the kids that made the video, the viral video that was on. I mean, didn't it make like Ellen? It was everywhere.
Everywhere. It was everywhere. And you know what? How could you not whip the Nadeade when it comes off?
Right?
Let's see you do one.
I cannot. I don't even know. Our kids do it, and I still don't know how to do it. Is that a whip?
Is this a
nay-nay?
It's a sad one, but yeah, that's a good, and that's a very a flamboyant nay-nay.
That's okay. Why we leave it up to the kids.
That's right.
Everyone has stopped for some reason, and I'm really wishing that they would move on.
I think they're just trying to cram all the whipping nay-nays.
Yeah, they get all the kids in the truck there. But yeah, Steve, coach of the Mighty Mites there.
Yay! Let's see you whip!
I don't even know what this is. I think I'm telling him to go away. I don't think that's a whip. So I apologize. It's like, go.
We'll get you one of the dance, you know, companies.
Metal Mirrors detailing. Consigli. This is Consigli Construction, I do believe.
Excellent.
With their season greetings truck with a whole bunch of people in the back throwing candy out.
Packages.
Everyone's dressed so festively as well.
Nice Christmas tree on the back.
Milford's Finest, of course, driving up and down the parade, making sure everyone is safe. We want to thank the Milford Fire Department and the Milford Police Department as well. Ah, music. He's dancing. He's got an H on his head. Is that Halston Hopedale, maybe? I don't know. But this is a nice thing about this parade is that we welcome other towns as well to join the fun.
Looks like they
we're not exclusive to Milford here.
We open it up
to everybody.
How long has this parade been running?
This parade has been 29 years.
Excellent.
So this is the 29th year. J&L property clean out and junk removal with their two trucks, dump truck and pickup truck. With Frosty the Snowman lit up on the top of that one.
We accumulate junk.
We do. They could come by, take a few things. So we have three or four yard sales a year. And then we go to yard sales, and that's why we need to have yard sales, because we accumulate junk at yard sales that we sell 6 months later at our own yard sale.
Tell me that's antiquing.
It's antiquing, yeah. So if you call it antiquing, then you can justify it. It's not junk picking.
No.
It's antiquing.
No.
Someone's front yard. And here comes the Starhawks youth hockey.
A lot of
kids. They're playing some rock and roll.
Goodness,
I just sounded like I was 80 years old, but they're playing some rock and roll in that book.
Those crazy kids.
I was trying to remember the name of the song. It's Ramblama, hey, Black Mama, Ramblama, or whatever it is. Blairhouse.
Oh, look at
our friends from the Blairhouse, they do a great job there. My friend Alyssa, who I grew up with back in Spencer, Mass. And there's Kyle Romano, who is driving right there. But, Alyssa works there. She's been working there for years, does a great job. Blair House, wonderful place. Arts Auto Service coming through with their, they have a few entries every year. Their tow truck, their Mac. Is that a Mac?
I think that's a big Mac.
Or it's a semi, it's a Mac, I don't know.
It's a good looking truck.
It's a big truck. And their flatbed coming up behind that for your towing needs, of course. Arts Towing and Auto Service. And they're all dressed up in the back there, too. It looks like, correct me if I'm wrong, is there a little Italian thing going on? The kids in the hats and the top
hair? It's either that or like a Where's Waldo thing.
Okay, because I can't really see right now, but I expect them to be like on a gondola.
Yeah, I think you might be right.
And the channels are... Anyway, well, we say hi to our friends at Arts Auto Service and towing as they come through. You want to come up? All right, let's talk to Rob for a few minutes from Milford TV. What's up, Rob?
Hi, Ray.
How's the broadcast going?
Oh, it's great. Liz is directing right now.
Yeah.
I think I'm about to break one of your
cords. Yeah, why don't you step down?
Okay.
There you go.
Too tall.
Is that better?
Yeah, it's good.
I thought it was going to help by swinging that under the table, and it's not.
It's great. It was a great event.
Yeah.
Oh, it's awesome. Everyone's so happy. It's amazing. Everyone's feeling the Christmas spirit.
Here comes the tradesman.
Oh, cool.
Rubber Chicken Comics. This has been the secret of the year. Hey, that's our Flash costume, by the way.
Oh, awesome. Oh, wow.
That's Rob. Is that Rob? No, that's not Rob. But some of our friends are up there. There's Catwoman. There's our friend Don as Catwoman. And,
oh, that is Don. What?
Yeah, Don is Catwoman. And there's Karen. Here's Karen as Cruella DeVille. Hi, Karen. Mwah. Great job on the float, Karen. That was a lot of fun. Our friends from the Tradesman and Rubber Chicken Comics, your first entry in the parade. What do you like so far?
Every float is really good.
Yeah.
Everyone has really worked hard, and the visuals are amazing. And I'd like to thank our crew.
Everyone
watches this on Milford TV. Malcolm Zale just running around like a madman.
I wonder where he gets that from.
I don't know. No one in his family has that kind of energy.
No.
Watch out.
Third place. Tradesman won third place for their flow.
Nice.
For them.
Wow.
I'm going to stand up here because I'm taller than you. I like this. Milford Youth Center coming by.
Wow, that's a
facilities.
Great float.
That is a good one. It's got the Minion and
cool.
The whole, what's the movie?
Despicable Me.
Despicable Me,
yeah.
The whole Despicable Me theme.
But they have their own movie, too, so.
Yeah, the Minions. I've seen it. It's awesome.
I just want to say, people need to, the floats are great, but people need to step up their candy game a little bit.
Yeah.
You
haven't gotten enough candy yet?
No, just better candy.
Oh,
that's
better
all.
Candy, yeah.
You know,
like full-size Snicker bars?
Thing is all right if you're over at grandma's house, you know, but...
It's funny that on Halloween, they go for the good stuff,
yeah.
But they'll throw out the hard candies.
Yeah.
It's almost like they're taking what they got that they didn't want at Halloween and using it for the Christmas parade.
Right. I think it's just leftovers from Halloween, yeah. But anyways, I'm just, you know, a nice gesture would be some better candy. That's all. Other than that,
okay,
this is
right?
An amazing event. Everything's going awesomely.
Highway Recovery. Going to recovery, and I got to come down because I'm not that tall. Tim Rice taking pictures throughout the parade. His first time here, by the way. Tim Rice's first
time
here.
Yeah, I couldn't believe that.
Yeah.
It's like, why, you know, it's kind of an event where you'd expect people to be taking a lot of photos. So.
Yep. I took photos years back, and then we do this now, so we're happy to have Tim here taking pictures. I don't know how necessary that is, like that part of the parade.
It's fun for people that don't have headphones on.
I can just imagine what this sounds like on the media center.
So here's David Squibb. David Squibb is our runner today. He's running around doing everything.
David's great. He's done stuff for us before for me.
Yep. He's always at the studio. We got Tyler Nastri on camera as well. We got Nick Harkins and Liz Harkins here. And we got Malcolm Zale and who else? And myself.
And yourself.
And Jim Lagore. Oh, Jim's covering his ears. How cute is that? Oh.
Well, if you remember last year, Jim, what he wore, he had a towel on.
Oh, yeah, he had a towel. He's cold. Yeah. He gets cold, and the noise is too much for him. He's got to cover his ears. He's like a little baby.
And then he disappears.
He's horrible. Yeah.
You all right, Jim? That is so cute. It is cute. Somebody's going to... Oh, it's Tim. Tim. I can't yell for Tim. Hey, Tim. Tim. Got a lot of paving coming up now. Coming by as we broadcast live from the town hall here in Milford for the Santa Parade, the Milford Santa Parade.
Oh, wow, look at that. We got some steam coming out there.
Look at that.
Who knows if that's safe or not. Hopefully it's not some noxious gas.
They've got presents in the front of that, whatever that is. It looks like some kind of paving.
That is a cool machine.
Equipment. Yeah, it's almost like a tank.
Yeah.
And I think they must use it to pave, I'm guessing.
I would hope so.
Devilacqua Paving always has a huge entry in the parade. There's one, two, three, it looks like four vehicles so far.
Yeah.
This one pulling a trailer with a Christmas scene. And look at that, it's Christmas morning.
Oh, that's cool.
There's a couch and some kids under the tree.
Are those real kids or are those animatronic kids?
Those
are real children?
Disney came in and helped.
Oh, I don't know how safe that is.
Oh, and they just got cold.
Cool.
The black one baby just got cold. That's sad.
Oh, it's the Grinch driving it. That's cool.
That is good. Look at that. The Grinch is driving that truck with the coal in the back.
That's a lot of coal. There's a lot of awful kids in Milford.
Oh. Can you see that? My eyes are going. Just last hope. Last hope, canine rescue. Driving by in their jacked up pickup truck.
That's cool. Oh, a kid on a longboard. Gingerbread man on a longboard.
Gingerbread man, that's a Christmas tree.
Well, there's a gingerbread man on the other side.
How do you see the other side?
And a Christmas tree. Look at.
That's great. Happy holidays from Green Street Auto Spa.
Seriously, look at that float, man.
That's a gingerbread
house. A lot of
work. Absolutely.
That was not here last year.
No,
that's
it wasn't.
Yeah.
Green Street Auto Spa, a friend of WMRC.
Oh, they're great. I bring my car there all the time.
You get oil changes, detailing, car wash.
Do you know, you can get an oil change, and if you ask, they'll give you a free car wash with it.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Depot Street Tavern, some of the best food in Milford. And there's Adam Hicks.
The salmon platter is amazing.
Look, they've got the Christmas story leg on the top.
Throw me a salmon platter.
They're giving out gift cards,
they
actually.
They should give out salmon platter.
They're giving out gift cards.
But what is that? Oh,
that's the Christmas story leg. Campos Detailing, another friend of WMRC. And I just got to say, once again, we've been there. Depot Street Tavern is amazing.
Yeah.
The food there is outstanding.
It's amazing.
Get there nice and early because
it gets packed.
It does.
When we went there for a staff lunch, I had to sit on the windowsill.
But it's worth it.
Oh, it was worth sitting on a windowsill as an adult man eating. It was worth it.
And Adam cooks fresh. He gets all of his ingredients locally, and everything is fresh. And it's just amazing to sit out there. Asphalt Engineering, Tom McAuliffe and his son Will join Asphalt Engineering, our friends who teamed up with us for Hometown Hope Initiative. Here comes their entries as we wave to them on their way by. Just great people at Asphalt Engineering, the whole crew there, wonderful people. And the fact that they teamed up with us for what we do in the community with Hometown Hope just makes them even more outstanding, giving back to the community. So we say hi to our friends at Asphalt Engineering.
What's this one? Oh, that's still asphalt. Wow.
So where's Tom McCall? Tom is somewhere.
Is that him? There he is.
He's throwing candy. Whoa, watch out, Molly. Watch your eyes. Everyone watch your eyes.
Yeah! That was heavy. Oh, this is good candy. Whoppers. Oh, my God. This is dangerous.
We're getting pelted with candy. Asphalt Engineering took my eye.
Yes. Look at that. That's amazing candy.
That's
Whoppers.
Candy.
Tootsie roll. I got a Tootsie Roll. I've been waiting for a Tootsie Roll.
And that's a classic
and a fruit chew. And Jim's.
That was scary. Yeah.
Shout out to Asphalt Engineering for some solid candy. That's great. Whoppers.
I wouldn't expect anything less from Asphalt Engineering.
I shouldn't eat this.
Those
now.
Guys are awesome. By the way, this parade is like 3 hours long. It's amazing.
It's the best parade
it's
I've ever
going.
Seen. It really is.
And thank you, by the way, for teaming up with us to do this. And
that's
we
great.
Do a lot together. And
it's fun.
Everything we do is fun.
And every year we add something new.
Don't tell my wife this because she's right behind me. But Jim LaGore and I came up with an idea.
Uh-oh,
to
that's
do
not
another
good.
Show. Well, you were there Friday after the show. We
when
talked
you guys
about
have
that.
Ideas.
So you might be looking for that soon.
I think it's a great idea you guys were talking about. We won't let anything
It's music related,
yet,
we'll say that.
Yeah, it's great.
And it's going to be a we'll team up with Milford TV to get that on the air.
Oh, what's that thing?
That is a elephant of sorts.
Is that the Toys for Tots elephant? What is that?
He's got something on him. There is a banner on the back of that car there. That festively decorated car. It's a learning exchange. It's a learning exchange,
oh, yeah,
folks.
We know that.
Yes. And everyone's dressed up. She's dressed up like a present. What's this float right there? That float that's coming by with
the... So those are annoying vendors. Yeah.
I was telling Molly that it's not Christmas until you get an inflatable SpongeBob on a stick.
That will break in 2 days. As I was saying, I used to work in Marlboro. We used to do the Labor Day Parade. That was a three-hour... parade.
Was it really? Wow.
They do it every year.
Yeah.
But this is so much better. It's a little bit shorter, but everything is just so engaging and vibrant. And it's I'd say it beats that parade. I know people from Marlboro don't want to hear that, but this beats that parade.
It's at night. Everyone decorates their car, so you get the lights.
Yep.
And I know a lot of parades that actually do their Christmas parades during the day, which I don't think you get the same effect.
Right.
I'm sure they're nice and all, but Medway does theirs at night. We're doing ours at night. 29th year here as we broadcast live. Birchler's Mobile coming through now. Mass
what has been your favorite yeah, so far?
The Italian Vets. I love the Italian
Vets.
Great. I think their energy is always top-notch.
Yep.
They have the members of the military, all the branches.
It's always a big float, too. It's always really big.
And it is rocking. And you know what? I'm very proud of my friends at the Tradesmen. I thought their float was a lot of fun as well with all the cast of characters. Because in the Tradesmen, there's already a cast of characters.
Oh, yeah.
Put costumes on them, and boom, mind blown.
Yep.
And I can't wait to watch the broadcast because I didn't really get a good look at who was in there. We saw Karen and we saw Don. And was Tommy in there? Was Tommy O'Toole on
I hope
the float?
Not.
I did not see him.
I hope he was hiding out somewhere.
I don't even know if Rob
I don't trust
did it.
Him in this kind of an atmosphere. I'm not sure that would work
I feel
well.
Weird being your height.
So I'm going to give it back to Molly. So
that,
I think towards the end.
You
so
think it's the end? You think
you guys can have a nice moment together on the radio.
Thank you.
All right, thanks, Ray.
Thank you, Rob.
It was fun this
thanks
year.
Thanks for all
you're
doing. Yes, absolutely. We'll do it again next year.
See ya.
Bye, everybody. This Ray. Well, he's saying bye. Oh, you want to jump back on? I have no idea when the end of this parade is going to be, but...
It's not. Look at this candy.
Actually, don't take that. This is Rob's candy.
I'm taking it.
No, he left it, so that's his own
he
problem there.
He likes me. He'll forgive me.
It may be wrapping up. And at the end, of course, is Santa Claus. And I think that is Santa Claus. This is a float they built, and they bought a sleigh. Teddy DiPaolo was telling me about this. They bought a sleigh. They What do you do when you
refurbished?
Refurbished it. They refurbished the sleigh. So this is going to be an amazing thing as it comes through. And we want to thank the Milford Fire Department for all they do with the parade. They put this on every year. It's an amazing event. This year was top-notch with the weather cooperating the way it did. That's amazing. And we want to thank everybody for coming out to the Milford Santa Parade. And thanks for listening on 1490, on our media center at WMRCDailyNews.com.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, thanks for coming on. And thanks to all of our guests who came on. It was a lot of fun to see everybody and have everybody on with us. And I can't wait to do this again next year. So I think we're gonna sign off in just a few minutes as Santa comes by.
I know him.
And he is on the back of the Birchler's
this looks amazing.
Automotive truck, the flatbed there, big flatbed. But there is Santa Claus, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be seeing him in a few weeks. Well, actually, you're not supposed to see him in a few weeks. If you see him, then that's a bad thing. But he is going to be visiting your house soon in a few weeks. And there's Malcolm Zale on top with Santa Claus. There's a photo opportunity. Look at that. Malcolm gets to hang out with Santa Claus. All right.
He's awesome.
Well, that was it. And there is Teddy right there. Thanks, Teddy, for all you do. Thank you. Great job. Great parade, Teddy. Teddy and the entire fire department here in Milford just did a bang-up job. They started with teaming up with Tri-Valley Front Runners for the two-mile run, which raised a lot of money. It goes back to the town and the fire department and all they do. Thank you, Joey. Great to see you.
Beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Calories.
The calories, wonderful people. Thanks to Justin Redden for coming on, Jim LaGore. Tim Rice, Will Kincaid. Who else was on? I think Tom called in from the asphalt engineering truck. And Rob from Milford TV. And that's it. So let's sign off. How about a hug before we go?
Aww.
It was so much fun. Bye, everybody. Merry Christmas,
Merry Christmas.
From the Auger and WMRC and Asphalt Engineering. Bye.